Holy Ghost, fire, 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 fire,
fire.
I command them to the abyss.
I command them to the abyss.
Anything which is not of God.
Anything which is not of God.
In my life.
In my life.
In my body.
In my body.
In my career.
In my career.
In our countries.
In our countries.
In every sector of my life.
In every sector of my life.
Catch fire now.
Catch fire now.
Catch fire now.
Catch fire now.
I command them.
I command them.
Come out.
Come out.
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 And I command them to the abyss.
I command them to the abyss.
Say, God Almighty, you are holy.
God Almighty, you are holy.
You are wonderful.
You are wonderful.
You are glorious.
You are glorious.
I love you so much.
I love you so much.
You are God of Abraham.
You are God of Abraham.
I worship you.
I worship you.
I adore you.
I adore you.
I love you so much.
I love you so much.
I surrender to you.
I surrender to you.
I open my heart.
I open my heart.
Say, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
You are my Lord.
You are my Lord.
You are my Savior.
You are my Savior.
Wash me with your blood.
Wash me with your blood.
Forgive me my sins.
Forgive me my sins.
Say, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
You are the Alpha.
You are the Alpha.
The Omega.
The Omega.
The King of Kings.
The King of Kings.
The Lords of Lords.
The Lord of Lords.
Wonderful.
Wonderful.
Counselor.
Counselor.
Mighty God.
Mighty God.
Everlasting Father.
Everlasting Father.
I worship you.
I worship you.
It's a wonderful Holy Ghost.
Wonderful Holy Ghost.
I surrender to you.
I surrender to you.
I open my heart.
I open my heart.
I open my spirit.
I open my spirit.
Teach me your word.
Teach me your word.
Reveal to me.
Reveal to me.
Your divine revelations.
Your divine.
Bless me tonight.
Bless me tonight.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
The Bible says that where two or three comes together in my name, Jesus said that there I am in their midst, and they will have a privilege to sing unto God tonight. Let us get ready to sing unto God tonight.
You are the need. It's a song we learned in Zimbabwe.
You are Alpha and Omega. We worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to be praised.
Sing it again.
You are
we give you all.
To go through the word of God and the word of testimony tonight.
Amen. Our testimony reads as follows. Blessed with a job, there is a man who called Pastor Robert last Saturday for prayer as he was going to a job interview on Monday. So on Monday he went to attend the interview in town. He got interviewed and was told to wait for the results. As he was waiting in town, he remembered about another company which is also situated in town. He sent an application via email and they responded the same time. They told him to come and write a test. He passed the test and was told to report to work the following day. He is hired after 2 years of unemployment. Amen.
Amen.
Our announcements are as follows. Every morning at 6 a.m. from Monday to Friday, we have our morning prayer, which is at 7 a.m. on Saturdays and Sundays. Our midday service starts at 5 to 12, and then we have our evening service, which starts at 6 p.m. every night. Our midnight prayer starts at 5 to 12 every night, and we also have our weekly prayer and fasting, which is on Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays. The details of the fasting are shared on our different WhatsApp groups. Amen.
Amen.
Tonight we will read the Word of God from the book of Luke, chapter 8, from verse 41, NIV. It reads as follows. Then a man named Jairus, a synagogue leader, came and fell at Jesus' feet, pleading with him to come to his house, because his only daughter, a girl of about 12, was dying as Jesus was on his way. The crowd almost crushed him, and a woman was there who had been subject to bleeding for 12 years, but no one could heal her. She came up behind him and touched the edge of his cloak, and immediately her bleeding stopped. "Who touched me?" Jesus asked. When they all denied it, Peter said, "Master, the people are crowding and pressing against you." But Jesus said, "Someone touched me. I know that power has gone out from me." Then the woman, seeing that she could not go unnoticed, came trembling and fell at his feet in the presence of all the people. She told why she had touched him and how she had been healed, and how she had been instantly healed. Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
Also tonight we'll have a privilege to go through the Word of God together, believing the Word of God to be taught with power, the power of the Holy Spirit, power to heal, power to bless, power to protect, power to deliver in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Let us go through the word of God from the book of Luke chapter 8 verse number 41. The Bible says that, "Then a man named Jairus, a synagogue leader, came and fell at Jesus' feet, pleading with him to come to his house." And verse number 42, the Bible says that because his only daughter, a girl about 12, was dying, and Jesus was on his way, the crowd almost crushed him. Then the Bible is talking about the man Jairus. The Bible said that Jairus was not just anybody. Jairus was a synagogue ruler, synagogue leader. And the Bible said that as Jairus was synagogue leader, but he had a problem. He had a problem that he realized. The problem was urgent. The problem was serious. He realized that his daughter was very sick. When he looked at it, you know, he realized that it is going to be a bit late to go to the hospital. It is going to be late to go to the doctor. And they say that, no, he have heard about Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the miracle worker, the healer. Then he ran to Jesus. When he arrived at the place where Jesus Christ was, the Bible says that he went there and came and fell at Jesus' feet. He went there and humbled himself and begged, "Jesus, can you please come and pray for my daughter? Can you please pray, come and pray?" He said, can you come and pray for his daughter? Because he realized that this case was serious. This case was serious. The case of his daughter was serious. And indeed it was serious. Because when you read down through the scriptures, that's when you hear that the Bible says that as soon as Jesus Christ was told he's in his way and he was hauled because of a miracle that just have happened, you hear about the daughter of Jairus died. The Bible says the daughter of Jairus died because the case was serious. Then Jairus was not just going to Jesus. He went to Jesus because it was indeed serious. As he arrived where Jesus Christ was, the Bible said that he humbled himself. He went there and forget that he's a synagogue ruler. He went there, he forget that he's a synagogue leader. You know, there is something that a challenge does. There is something that a problem does. Where Jairus now, because he is in challenge, he's having a problem, he's humbling himself like that. That's why sometimes we say that problems are a callback from God. Sometimes the problem we face in life, the challenges we face in life, are just a callback from God. God wants sometimes people to humble themselves. Because I can tell you, if there was no problem like this, if there was no challenge like this, Jairus was not just going to bow before Jesus, but he was a synagogue leader. You remember when you talk about synagogue ruler, synagogue leader? Do you remember Nicodemus? The Bible said that Nicodemus was a people of such. And the Bible said that when he wanted to go to Jesus, he goes during the night. And the reason why he's going to see Jesus during the night is because he's conscious of his status. He's conscious that he's a synagogue ruler. He's conscious that he's a synagogue leader. But if he was going there because there was a problem, I'm telling you, he wouldn't care. He was going to come during the day. He was going to go to Jesus during the day, and he would not care about anybody. When things are well, when things are going well, you can care about what people say. You will care, you can care about what people think. But when things are out of hand, you don't care. You just need help. Like Jairus this time does not care whether his colleagues are going to see him, that is going to Jesus. Because remember, a synagogue leaders were under the council of Jewish religion. With Jewish religion, they were not really accepting Jesus Christ by this time. In which, if things were well, he was going to care what other leaders are going to say about this. But because he realized that the situation is worse, he doesn't care. He doesn't care what people say. He doesn't care what people think. He just wants Jesus to give him attention so that he can pray for his daughter. When I'm hearing about this story, it reminds me of the story of Jairus, of the story of Bartimaeus. Now the Bible says that Bartimaeus, we know the story, we have talked about several times. Bartimaeus was blind. And because of his disability, the Bible says that he used to sit by the roadside. He will wait for people to pass. When people were passing, he will ask for money. And the Bible said that as he was sitting there, he began to hear the loud noise. And when he began to ask what was happening, they told him that today Jesus Christ of Nazareth is passing by. Say, what is happening? They told him that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is passing by. When he began to hear that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is passing by, the Bible said that Jairus began to shout. Imagine a blind man, the man who can't see. But the Bible said that when he began to hear that Jesus Christ is passing by, he began to shout, Son of David, have mercy on me. Son of David, have mercy on me. I don't know which side you are, but just have mercy on me. I don't know who you are walking with, but just have mercy on me. I can't see where you are, who you are with, but I don't care. Have mercy on me. Please see me. Do something. And the Bible said that when Jairus was shouting like that, there were other people who were working with Jesus. They were like, Bartimaeus, you are making noise. Bartimaeus, shut up. But Bartimaeus, because he knew that he had been blind for years, he knew his predicament, he knew his problem, he's tired. Because he's tired, he doesn't care. He doesn't care who says what. He doesn't care what people think, whether he's disrupting order. He doesn't care. He just wants Jesus' attention. I'm talking to somebody tonight. When your problem is too small, you still care about what people think. You still care what other people will say. You are still quite careful. If you are still able to hold decorum, is because your problem is not too much. But when problem is beyond what you can bear, and Jesus Christ is your last bus stop, you wouldn't care. You will develop a Bartimaeus character automatically. You will develop a Jairus character. a character of someone who doesn't care what people say, who doesn't care what people think. Because by this time you get out of a comfort zone. It's a time where you get out of a comfort zone. Then sometimes God is looking for you. God wants to fellowship with you. God wants to walk with you in spirit and in truth. And sometimes he allows the callback so that you can come out of your comfort zone. He wants you to come out of a comfort zone so that you can shout like a Bartimaeus. So that you can kneel like a Jairus. No, because you know, when things are well, when things are going well, you know, Jairus is a synagogue leader. There is a certain gowns he wears. There is a certain decorum when he walks. He cares about what people think. He cares. You know, he want to feel like a leader. But when he come out of a comfort zone, he doesn't care. Sometimes God, he wants you to get out of a comfort zone until you reach a time and a place where you don't care. When you don't care and you are just looking for Jesus' attention. At this time is a time and a place where you get to be disparate. We need to reach a level where you get to be disparate. God is found in desperation. If you want a miracle, if you want God to bless you, God to change your story, you need to be desperate.
You know, the Bible talks about, you know, like what we're hearing about,
what you are about to read about in verse number 43 of Luke chapter 8, where the Bible says that, and a woman was there who had been subjected to bleeding for 12 years. And no one could heal her. She came up behind him and touched the edge of his cloak, and immediately her bleeding stopped. The Bible talks about this woman also. You see, this woman, the Bible says that she has been sick. You know, in other scriptures, in other verses, they will tell you that this woman, she has been sick. She was not sick for one. She was not sick for 2 years, for 3 years, for four. The Bible said that for about 12 years. And the Bible said that because she was sick, she tried to even go to many doctors.
And the Bible said that as she got to many doctors,
she even spent all she had when she was looking for solution. When she was looking for her breakthrough. And the Bible said that as she was looking for the breakthrough, looking for the miracle, for 12 years nothing could work. Nobody could solve her problem.
And the Bible said that instead of getting better, she grew worse. When she had grown worse, the Bible said that also this day, she heard that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is passing by. When she began to hear that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is passing by, she began to tell herself,
if I just touch the hem of his garment, I will be healed.
If I just touch.
I know he's a miracle worker. I have heard he's a miracle worker. I have heard the miracles that he has performed. I don't need to get his attention. But if I touch the hem of his garment,
my problems knee shall bow, my challenge knee shall bow.
My situation must change.
this woman also, she was tired of her problem. You need to reach a level where you are tired. Be tired. And you don't care. You know, there's a level where you are not supposed to care. You are looking for a miracle. You are looking for a situation to change. She get out of her comfort zone. And the Bible said that on this day, there was a huge crowd. That's what the Bible said that in the book of Luke chapter 8 verse number 42, stand up, the Bible says, as Jesus Christ was on his way, the crowd almost crushed him. Because there were a lot of people who were there. Even though there were a lot of people who were there, but this woman was so determined. This woman in the midst of the crowd, she said, today, I don't know how many people are there. I will make a way. I will touch his garment. I will touch his garment. I will try by all means. You see, because she believes. And now because she believes, the Bible said that she touched his garment. Without Jesus Christ even aware, without Jesus Christ even expecting that somebody is about to touch the hem of his garment. But this woman was determined that today, I must touch his garment. I must touch his garment, and if I touch his garment, doesn't matter what the doctor have said. It doesn't matter who have said what. But my problem by fire, by force, must bow. The Bible said that since the time of John, the Bible say that the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violent one take it by force. Sometimes you need to get out of your comfort zone. When you get out of your comfort zone, you take your miracle by force. And you say, Jesus, you are a miracle worker. What I've heard is not a story. I've experienced your power before, and I believe you're still the same yesterday, today, and forever. Then by fire, by force, my situation must change. I don't know your schedule. Maybe you are going to the house of Jairus, but you are not gonna pass me by. You are not going to pass me by. I'm not gonna accompany you to the house of Jairus, and I witness the daughter of Jairus coming back to life, and I remain sick. By fire, by force, that anointing must touch me. By fire, by force, I must carry my miracle. My situation must change.
Amen.
Sometimes, get out of your comfort zone. Demand that anointing. The Bible says that since the time of John, the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violent one shall take it by force. Take your miracle by force. Katalamano it. And say, if the anointing is here, by fire, by force, my situation must change. The anointing cannot just open the blinders of Bartimaeus. Same time, and my situation take long. My situation, by fire, by force, anointing must touch you. And by fire, by force, you must change. And the Bible said that woman, immediately a brigada command that lasted for 12 years, it bowed. I'm saying to you tonight, I don't know what is your predicament. I don't know what is your problem. I don't know what is your challenge. But that problem must bow. That challenge must bow.
That situation must turn around for your good. Must turn around for your good. Because child of God, anointing works. Anointing works, and it works more than a magic. It won't be right when I tell you that anointing works like a magic. But anointing works more than magic. That's why we have got what we called a mere instant miracle. It is when the anointing touches and the situation changes now. I don't know what is your situation. I'm saying to you today, be tired of it. Tap to the anointing tonight. As you are tapping to the anointing tonight, something is happening in your life in Jesus' name. Something is happening in your life in Jesus' name. Something is happening in everywhere. You need a miracle in Jesus' name. Something is happening. Something is happening. Begin to pray. Connect to that anointing. Put a demand like this woman. Put a demand like this woman who sent Jesus by fire, by force. Something must happen. That yoke must break. You must carry your miracle. I don't know who the anointing is touching, on what kind of, which sector of your life you want the power to touch. Allow it to touch as you're praying wherever you are. Just pray. Believe it to touch. Believe it to touch. He's ready to solve your problem. If you have done it for this woman, he can do it for you. He can do it for you. He can do it for you. Arakashio ketere bekete. Arakaya karaba sokoto rokoshia. Mekerebe. Arakashi kotola katiaba. Barekato rokoshia karabakadi. Enkinton prada katabakadi. Santikia toko rokoshia karabakata. Jan tokotoria katarabakatia. Enchekete kelekete. Shanda lakato rokoshia kata. Zente kete bakata rakashi kete riaka. Ekete, 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 ekete. Zakaria, orokotia. Power of God, touch us tonight. Touch us tonight, one by one. Do what no man can ever do in our lives. We need your touch. Orakashia katarakashia kete kete. Akadia karabaka chegeri akata. Zanto kotoko roko shakatorobo. Zente kete kerekeshia kataraba. Alakatoroko shia karabakate. Ezekete kerebashia katalaba. Ando bazanda laba jende lebezi ando loko. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, fire, 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 fire. I command them to the abyss. Anything which is not of God in my life, in my body, in my career, in our country, in every sector of my life. Catch fire now. Catch fire now. I command them. Come out. 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 everything to turn around for my good.
Everything
turn around for my good. So let there be progress. Progress, progress, progress. So let there be miracle jobs, miracle jobs. In the name of Jesus Christ. Say, Lord Jesus Christ, you are my Lord. You are my Savior. Wash me with your blood. Forgive me my sins. Bless me today. Protect me from today. From today, I am born again. I am saved. Say, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Ghost, be with us all. Surely goodness and love shall follow me all the days of my life. And I dwell in the house of the Lord forever. In the name of Jesus. And also tonight, this is a reminder, tomorrow is Thursday. We are praying, we are fasting, and the prayer points will be shared in our different WhatsApp group. And I want to say tonight, may God bless you. Have a blessed and a wonderful night in Jesus' name.
Bye bye, everybody. Have a blessed morning, day, and afternoon and night.
Amen. Bye bye.
Amen. Bye. Bye.